what's your discomfort zone after you quit drinking? How long is it going to last? And what does it involve? Let's go walking. How you doing? I'm Kevin O'Hara for alcoholmastery.com. Today I wanted to talk about your discomfort zone and learning how to be uncomfortable with yourself, right? You know, what is your discomfort zone? You know, what does it involve? How long is it going to last? You know, what are you going to feel? These are all questions which are sort of impossible to answer, right? In the grand scheme of things, from a personal perspective, I can tell you exactly what I went through. I can tell you what some people go through. And I can tell you that most of your discomfort zone is constructed and managed and upheld within your own mind, right? So a lot of the discomfort involves is great in some people because they haven't prepared enough, right? Because they haven't done their own homework. They haven't thought about it in the right way. They've thought about it in a completely negative aspect. None of us like discomfort, you know, let's put it out there, you know, I mean, in any shape, way or form. You know, most people won't eat vegetables, for instance, because they don't taste that great, you know? They don't taste as good as four cheeses pizza with pepperoni slices and pineapple smeared all over it, right? That's why people, most people won't eat that kind of stuff. It's why a lot of people are obese. It's why a lot of people, you know, 90%, 85, 90% of people who are in hospitals are there because of stuff they've done to themselves. You know, we've got the Western diseases of heart disease, of diabetes, of arthritis. All these killer diseases are caused by the food that we're eating, caused by all the crap that we're putting into our bodies, right? But people don't want to stop doing that because they don't want to feel the discomfort of doing something different. And they believe that this discomfort is going to last a long time, right? So, you know, people won't change their diets because they believe, well, you know, if I change what I'm doing now, then I'm going to have to eat this crappy, horrible food for the rest of my life. You know, this is all your taste buds. And, you know, I often talk about when you quit drinking alcohol, that your body gets a tolerance to the alcohol, right? It gets after a while you have to drink more, right? Alcohol is an acquired taste, right? So in the beginning, nobody likes to drink fucking alcohol. It's all horrible stuff, you know. They don't like the taste of it. They don't like the way it makes them feel. And it's only after a while that we get an acquired taste of these things. And it's exactly the same thing with food. You know, you get an acquired taste to vegetables and beans and lentils and rice. And, you know, I'm going through this same sort of thing now in my life with salt, I'm trying to eliminate as much of the salt as I can, you know. And, you know, at first I tried to just eliminate the whole thing, you know. That's very difficult. You can't eliminate salt in general just the same way as you can't eliminate all alcohol from your life, because your body produces a certain amount of alcohol. There is a certain amount of salt in the foods that you're eating, even if it's coming out of the ground, right? There's a certain amount of salt as a mineral inside inside the food. But to try and eliminate it is, I'm always a big salt eater. You know, I'd eat 2 teaspoons, 3 teaspoons of salt a day, and it's not good for you, you know? So what I've done is I've tried to stop putting salt onto my meals, right? You know, sprinkling salt over the top, and that's working so far. And my body, my mind, is gradually getting used to it. It's gradually getting used to not having salt on my diet, you know, to having that taste. When I do go out for a meal and it's a highly salted meal, like some of the curries that we go for, you really taste the salt in, you know? And I'm sort of going for, you know, asking them, don't put any extra salt in the food. But I'll talk about a different perspective. You know, when you're talking about vegetables and, you know, people eating vegetables, you know, it's, you know, it's sort of exactly the same thing as people losing weight, or people exercising, or people doing the things that they know they should be doing in their lives, you know, getting through those things that they know will make a difference. And it's because they don't like the discomfort. You know, if you haven't exercised, if you've never exercised before, or if you haven't exercised in a long time, then exercising is going to be tough. You know, exercising is going to give you discomfort, a lot of discomfort in some cases. So, you know, it's it stops a lot of people from doing that one thing, you know, whether it's going out and running or walking or doing press-ups, sit-ups, whatever it is, right? It stops people from doing it because they don't want to feel that. A lot of people just won't do these things because they cause them discomfort, you know. There's other things like saving is an uncomfortable thing in the modern society because we're so programmed to spend, you know, we're consumers. So saving is another one that people don't want to do. Speaking up for themselves, speaking in public. You know, there's so many different things that cause discomfort, but if you could get over the discomfort, will bring great benefits to your life, right? You know, we spend our whole life sort of running in the opposite direction from discomfort, you know. All we want to do is stay in that comfort zone where we're nice and comfortable. No pain, but no gain. You know, static, stagnancy, you know. And I think if you bring your life into that sort of area where you're thinking about, you know, what I was talking about earlier on with the alcohol brings you tolerance and, you know, you get used to certain things, then it's not only stagnation if you stay in your comfort zone, you never do anything outside of it. If you don't do anything, that's going to bring you discomfort. You sort of come backwards, you go backwards in your life, you know. I think it really brings chaos into somebody's life, you know, conflict. And because, you know, our whole, the whole thing about human beings is growth and movement. And you know, when you're going against that and you're not doing that and you're not pushing yourself outside of your comfort zone, you're going against your own human nature, you know. I mean, and getting outside your comfort zone is one of the best skills that you can learn, and it is a skill. It's something that we're born with, right? Where, you know, when you're a young kid, you've got no problem with trying different things, trying new things, you know, experimentation, saying, yeah, I'm going to do this today, or yeah, I'm going to do that today. You don't even think about it in that sense. You just do it, you know. There is no, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. It's just do. And we forget that, you know, when, as we get older. And I know myself, you know, it's a form of laziness, you know. It's, we get so attached to the things that we've got, that, you know, the places that we are, people that we're with. We don't want to rock the boat in any way. And, you know, I think this is half the problem with drinking. It's getting too comfortable with what we know, even when that comfort is going to bring us more discomfort in the long run. You know, it's going to give us, you know, think about all the shit that is going to happen to you because of your drinking. If you don't stop, if you carry on drinking, you know, what's going to happen? Nothing good anyway. So, you know, you've really got to learn the skill of being uncomfortable in your life. And it's a learnable skill. It's something that you can learn. You know, quitting drinking is always something which is going to put you outside of your comfort zone. You know, there's no doubt about that because of the nature of it. You know, you, You're just used to doing this all the time. You're used to drinking. You're used to drinking to whatever it is that you do. You know, we're used to drinking as a means of running away from our discomfort zones. As soon as something strikes us as being uncomfortable, then we drink. As soon as something is a bit stressful, we drink. As soon as we think, well, I can't handle this situation, then first thing we do is drink. You know, it's one of the things that I see all the time, one of the things that I feel sometimes in my own life, even now, when my father died, I didn't really give it a thought, right, if I'm being honest. It wasn't something that I thought about in a negative term. It was something that I thought about in terms of, yeah, my father has just died, and this would have been a natural part of me, would be to have a wake and be a big part of the wake. There was a wake. Everyone was drinking. Everyone was getting drunk. Everyone was dealing with their problem in that way. And I dealt with it in my own way, which was to think about my dad and think about the times that I'd had with him, and talk about the times that I'd had with him, talk about, you know, those, do you remember this time with all my family? You know, do you remember when he did this, or do you remember when he did that? And remember when he said this or that? And smiling and being happy to celebrate his life, you know. And I got up the next morning and I remembered all those stories that we told, all the laughing that we'd done. Whereas half my family got up and they were had dirty big hangovers. You know, and I'm just saying, from my perspective, I'm glad I'm not there anymore, that I didn't think about doing that. I didn't need to do that. You know, it wasn't an automatic thing. And it's because my comfort zone has stretched way beyond alcohol. You know, alcohol is not a factor anymore. I've got over the discomfort of quitting drinking. I've got over the discomfort of alcohol being in any part of my life now. I've been to weddings, I've been to a funeral, I've been to many birthday parties, many dinners, and to meet him through many situations where alcohol has been a part, or would have been a part of my life beforehand, and isn't a part now. And I'll say that I learned something from each one, and I didn't learn something deliberately. And it wasn't the fact that I was saying, well, yeah, I need to sit down and think about this and think about the lessons that this is going to give me. But it just built on a little bit of strength, built a little bit more experience to what I'd already had before, to what I'd gone previously, right? And it gave me a little bit more knowledge about myself and my abilities and self-confidence. And that's what happens. You build bit by bit. You know, when you're going forwards, you're moving away from alcohol, and you've got your aim onto something out there in front of you, whatever it is, right? Take it easy, you know. Break things down into small chunks and easy chunks, and you're basically pushing against the outside of your comfort zone. You're getting slightly into your discomfort zone, slightly, little bits at a time, bit by bit, you're moving forwards. And as you do that, you do build self-confidence, you build momentum, you educate yourself naturally, right? It's not something that you deliberately have to do. It's something that happens as a part of the process of living, right? And just as we grow accustomed, you have to grow accustomed to drinking alcohol in the first place, and you have to acquire the taste, you have to, you know, grow accustomed to that. That's a part of your life. You know, if you brought yourself back to when you were a teenager and you first started drinking, would you ever have thought that you would be in the position you are now, where you're drinking whatever it is that you're drinking and you want to stop? And I'm not talking about wanting to stop, I'm talking about, you know, looking at yourself from back then, looking down on yourself as you're drinking, you know, as you're consuming. I've got a video or two of myself when I was absolutely plastered, right? And it's just a disgrace, you know, when I look back at it now. I don't know if I'm ever going to post those online. Maybe one day. But it is a disgrace. And if when I look at myself in those videos, if you think the first video that I made was bad, maybe I'll put a bit up sometime. But we all know where we are. If you've ever done that and you've ever looked at that, you know, look at it from that old perspective of when you're younger and you're looking forward, not at a video, but, you know, like say you could have transported yourself into the future and looked down on yourself. I would have seen this fat, baldy bloke, overweight, being drunk, you know, being plastered, talking about how miserable my life was, basically bitching and moaning and saying this was shit and that was shit, and getting upset with the whole thing, making myself upset with the whole thing. And, you know, that person was, it's just a, you know, it's good to have those videos because, you know, even I'm never going to go back there, but, you know, like if ever sort of my wildest dreams, maybe something really bad will happen and I don't know. I don't think I'm ever going to be in that position, but, you know, what if, right? It's a good video to look back on and go, yeah, fuck that. I'm never going to be in that position again. I never want to feel like that, look like that. But again, you know, this is a skill that you can learn. It's you learn through practice, you learn through doing, you learn through putting yourself into little uncomfortable situations, you know. I mean, if you want a bit of a discomfort today, what you can do, just do it for 5 seconds, right, is get into a cold shower. Just stand underneath the shower, turn the thing down to its coldest setting, stand underneath the head, and whack it on for 5 seconds. Can you do that? You know, this is something that is not going to kill you. It's not going to do anything bad to you, but it will give you discomfort. You know, there's a great TED talk on this. Just put in cold shower TED, TED, and there's a young guy and he's talking about it. And he's saying basically, if you can't do that, if you can't feel the discomfort for 5 seconds of having cold water splashed across your skin, right? Nothing bad, right? It's not a whip, it's not going to cause you any harm. Then how do you expect yourself to be able to put up with other kinds of discomfort in your life? And, you know, you might be thinking, well, you know, what's the point in that? There's no point in putting myself under the pain or the anguish or whatever it is that you think about of having a cold shower. There is a point. It builds your discomfort. It builds your skill of discomfort, of accepting discomfort. I guarantee you, this one skill, if you can build it, keep pushing yourself little by little outside of your comfort zones, this one skill will help you with so many different areas of your life. Because all change requires you to step out of your comfort zone. And all stepping out of your comfort zone is a step into your discomfort zone, a place where we don't naturally like to be, right? Quitting drinking alcohol involves stepping out of your comfort zone and into your discomfort zone. But once you step out of that comfort zone, your discomfort zone, if you stay there, will become, your comfort zone will stretch, right? And it will now encompass what used to be part of your discomfort zone, right? So, you know, you get out of the shower. Oh, get out of the shower. I've got the shower in my head because, you know, it's a psychological thing, right? I don't like doing it, but I do it every so often, right? And I do it for 30 seconds. And it kills me in my head to do it, right? But that's the only place that it kills me, because it refreshes my body. I feel great after I've done it. Now, it does make me feel like, oh, God, that was good, you know? But the idea is a complete head mind fuck up, right? It's the idea more than anything else that stops you from doing it. If you don't think about it, you just get in there and do it, that's when you get the it's easy, you know? So, where was I saying? Yeah, you know, push yourself outside your comfort zone in little ways, and you gradually expand your comfort zone, right? So you expand it to encompass what used to be your discomfort zones, right? What used to feel uncomfortable, what used to feel strange, is now you've changed, you know? And what you've changed into is somebody that can tolerate this, has got used to doing this, has got self-confidence in doing this, right? And that's what it's all about. You know, push yourself past. Don't wait for the right time. Don't wait until things are perfect and until the stars are aligned, until everyone's ready for you to quit drinking, because that's not going to happen. Never. Perfection is something that will stop you from doing everything, you know. It will just lead you to stop in your tracks and just go, well, if I can't be perfect in this, you know, it leads you to stagnation. So put yourself out and do it now. Put yourself into your discomfort zone for a while. It's not going to last long. It'll gradually decrease the discomfort over time, and you'll get there, you know. And you won't, if you focus on your future and focus away from the alcohol, you will quickly find yourself leaving alcohol behind you, because, like I say, what you focus on is what grows in your life. So, you know, if you focus on the alcohol, that's what's going to grow. If you focus on your future, that's what's going to grow. If you focus on the discomfort, that's what's going to grow. So focus on the future, your future, your plans. What do you really want to do in your life? What do you really, really want to do in your life? What's your ultimate dream for yourself? And start pursuing it and break it down into small chunks and step out of your comfort zone little by little and do it like that, you know. There's no point in stepping outside your comfort zone a little by little when you're quitting drinking, right? That's just something that you have to do. Stop doing it. All this bollocks about, well, if I cut down from 20 to 19 this week, and then I cut down from 19 to 18. Really? You know, if you've got a medical condition, right? If you're really, you know, there are some people that need to do this because they just can't stop, right? But most people are not in that position, right? 95%, 99% of people are not in that position. Most people are just afraid and afraid of what's going to happen after they stop drinking. So don't be that person. You don't have to be. You're just prolonging the agony, you know? For years and years and years, I prolonged the agony of smoking, of quitting smoking. I put myself through the same torture over and over and over again. And it was just pointless. Instead of just going, no, that's it, I'm not going to drink anymore, or I'm not going to smoke anymore, I just kept going back and, oh no, I'll have one, or I'll smoke a cigar. I was looking for an excuse to start smoking again, and tricking my mind, tricking myself into believing that, well, yeah, I can still smoke, but I've really given up at the same time. You know, and it just led me back to the same thing, same with moderation with alcohol. You know, you trick your mind into believing that you still need alcohol in your life, that you still need this toxin in your life, you know, that you need, you don't call it the toxin, you call it, you need your few cans of beer, your few cans of bird, your few pints of Guinness, your couple of scotches, whatever it is, you know, it's all in the head, you know. So when you're quitting drinking, there is no easy way to do this. It's stop doing it, and then gradually ease yourself into your new life. Do these things bit by bit, you know, focus on one thing at a time and make gradual progress. So look, this has gone way beyond, Jesus, that's a long video, this one. If you have any comments or questions, leave them down below. Give us a like, share, subscribe to the channel if you want to see more of these videos. There's one every single day, so come on over to the website and you can sign up for, we've got a course there on the newsletter. Just sign up for the newsletter. It's a daily newsletter, so you'll get an email every single day. So if you're trying to quit drinking, it's a daily reminder, right, of what you should be doing, right? It's a daily thing. It's going to come into your inbox with a different video, different message every day. Some of them are positive messages about what you can achieve when you quit drinking alcohol, and some of them are going to be looking on the negative side of carrying on drinking. You'll never hear a negative message from me about quitting alcohol, you know. It's all good. Until next time, stay safe, keep the alcohol out of your mouth. Push yourself outside of your comfort zones bit by bit. But on the main thing, stop drinking straight away. Don't put any more into your mouth, you know. That's the trick here. You know, there is no other way to do this. It's stop it, focus on the future. Forget about shit like cold turkey as well. It's not cold turkey. It's cold turkey. What is that? It's another trick of the mind. That's another video. I'm Kevin O'Hara for alcoholmastery.com. Onwards and upwards.